Well, two LB10s, three SRM6s is very similar to an LB20 and four SRM6s, so.
Yeah, the only thing is, I found this out when we were rolling smoke irons last time. You are down that extra SRM6, which can break something a little bit quicker. Alex and I have been running these two CAs in Solaris and just breaking Kodiaks left and right.
All right, we got a map up. What are we doing?
I put the link. It's already on Terra Therma for you guys. It's in Discord.
I like that my roommate has stayed.
It's probably because we're too lazy.
All right.
Team two.
Yeah, Tam, go get Kappa. Come back, golf six. The rest of us group up, Gamma. Pushed Hotel 7. I actually really liked their push that they did around here last time. I really like that. Or not there. Was it that one?
Well, they came in Fox 8, Golf 8 around that way.
Yeah.
And then we kind of pushed and all strung out.
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying I really like that maneuver as opposed to coming up the choke point here. I don't like that. That's not good.
So Tam will do some quick scouting from Golf 6, Golf 7 as he gets back to the main body.
Yep. I actually really like that maneuver they did.
Our Lance is good?
Yeah.
You want another fast mech to maybe pop out and grab Epsilon? Or are they going to be too close to that?
That's their look at where their spawn is. It's literally one grid square away.
But they might have it capped and be gone by the time we get over there.
By the time we get there, I think firepower will be more needed.
We'll play it by ear. We'll see how it goes.
No plan survives first contact with the enemy.
Well, some plans do.
Now, like, if you tell me who said that, I'll be impressed.
Wasn't that Sun Tzu?
No, it was Patton.
You're not, wrong on both.
No,
World War One. I'm not saying they didn't say it, but the original quote was a German staff officer in World War One. Wikipedia will have it for you. I just don't remember his name.
So we could just say like Hans Zimmer, and you'd be like, ah, yes, because it's German.
Yeah, not Bob. Not Bob said that.
Oh, not Bob. I forgot to mention it to you. I actually will not be here tomorrow for the scrim or the match with Smoke Adders.
Well, shit.
All right. We're down three.
Is your name off the signups?
No, because I just found out that I won't be.
Okay.
That's how they would tell them. So if we may need to do an emergency move this to week 7. So think about it now, Bob.
Yeah.
Oh, Moki. It was Moki.
Yeah, I just looked it up.
Sensors online.
I also just deleted.
Weapons online.
All right, here we go. We're in.
Was that Op4 that did the push around, or was that?
No, it was Smoke Adders. We've only played Smoke Adders on
this map, right?
Contact. Alpha Fox 7.
Use Discord, please.
Do we have a what it was?
It was a medium.
We're here.
Bridge Gulf 8.
Yep, follow the Shadowhawk.
Get in front, Miss Lux.
See anything, Devesh?
Alpha, they're coming from F7.
Right. New target acquired.
The lights in those quick mediums get to FC. Let's try and bait them into our trap. Everybody else stack or keep.
Oh, I guess we're not going across.
Target acquired.
So pull back from Epsi?
No.
Don't cross the open anymore, guys. They have the fire line down there.
Lights, get around to Fox 7, come up behind them. And Devesh. Devesh, you're a light. Black 6, you stay with us. Black 6, you stay with us.
I'm coming back. You stand close to the wall.
New target acquired. Fox 7, everybody push up towards Theta. Lights hold.
A good start.
Take six.
Holding the resource points, warriors.
Target spotted.
Get Alpha real close to
them. They're coming after the lights. They're coming after us.
New target acquired.
Let's go in. It's gonna turn around on us.
Let's get to Delta 7.
Alpha primary target hunchback 2C, right torso.
Light, you're blocking.
They've turned. Let's get back into it now, lights. Sorry, guys. Battles in Theta. Many UAVs. Alpha, CT.
New target acquired.
Team, you have about 200 lead on us. 200 lead.
Heat level critical.
Bravo, Nike, rear torso.
You gotta push in, the lights are pushing in.
I'm gonna need help over here in Gulf 7.
New target acquired.
Z, what's the target?
Lights came around back. Lights have come around back.
New target acquired.
Delta storm.
Target the bigger bags.
New target acquired.
Two behind us, the lights behind us. Multiple lights.
Does it mean you shut up? Hands down.
Lock on target, guys.
Bravo, bravo.
Bravo, hit the CP.
Nightgear.
Everyone, bravo, Nightgear.
Bravo, Nightgear. Bravo, Nightgear, where?
Doesn't matter, just go on bravo. Get in with the main group. Engage Delta Stormcrow in Echo 7.
CT.
Delta was caught a good 2 minutes ago.
And we'll know where nobody was shooting it. Alright, Fox 7, everyone go Fox 7.
I'm out, I'm late.
Everyone go Fox 7.
New target.
I'm gonna stuck back here. Too late.
Echo primary target.
Arctic Cheetah legs, Echo. Start decapping, guys. Start decapping.
New target acquired. Artillery strike online. New target acquired.
Lake Bushwhacker stand in Theta.
Copy.
New target acquired. New target acquired.
seems close. Once again, we split and no target was called for the longest time. That was a problem. We split ourselves and didn't focus a single target.
Well, the bushwhacker was called and I couldn't find it forever. No, it wasn't called where it was.
Which is the problem with splitting in the first place. Now, sometimes splitting works, but when you die and you're calling the targets, you gotta say, I'm dead, I can't see so-and-so, you call the target.
I wasn't
dead. Be positive.
Whatever it is. Shutdown. Like, I couldn't call a new target.
And I get you. That's great, but just like we were saying in the previous match, we're waiting for guidance. Drop three.
I just have one small takeaway. I noticed somebody mentioned that I think it was a night gear was legged. I echoed that call. And there was a few instances when I saw people continuing to shoot torsos afterwards. It's a leg mech. You got to concentrate the other one.
Well, just got to press freaking R and focus on the target that's called. All right, drop three. We have Pooh in an Atlas D, Tam in the Assassin, Black in a Bushwhacker, Z in Arctic Wolf, Napa Blood Eagle, Orion 2Cs, Noble in night gear, Hectic in a Warhammer. Go to your mech's next map.
I guess you can put Tevesh in spectate.
Let's drop out for a minute.
Make sure you guys drop out of groups so we can re-invite you to lobby. NZ, can I get company command, por favor? Thank you. Alright, depending if they set up Alpha or Charlie, I'm gonna have our lights grab either Kappa or Epsilon. Main body is gonna head up Delta 5, Ek 5, and rotate around towards the Fox 5 over there. We are Brawl, so we're gonna try and stay close to the Caldera as possible. Rotate that way. If they end up taking center, we'll just try and push up through the lines over there and get them. Just stay in NASCAR, just keep in mind the Atlas is slow.
By light.
Assassins, yeah. Whatever the quick mediums are. Assassin and Arctic Wolf. As long as the D, I think it's AC-20 and 3 SRM-6s, I think, or something like that. What about the, do you have the Atlas K? Okay, yeah, no problem. Yeah, then it'll be just the D, and just do what you can with that.
I think the RS also has the same armor quirks.
Hey, does there? Yeah, then get that one as well.
But the RS has all of its energy in the arms.
I just want to bring something up. I was looking back at the scoreboard. And all things being equal, there that guy named Ghost Padlin, and the other one is, it looks like Isender, their top scorers. Well, not just something to keep in mind, I guess.
Doesn't really mean too much. I mean, we got split. We let them kill us. That's really what it was.
In both games, are their top scorers. I just thought it was important to know.
We don't really look at names. We look at chassis and what they're in, and we focus the primary chassis.
Unless it's not Bob on the other team, and you focus the not Bob.
If you can catch the not Bob.
We can smell them.
And in this case, like I said, they're outpacing their teammates by quite a bit, so.
I hear cocaine smells like gasoline.
Both times they're the Arctic Cheetah and Stormcrow Prime, which are also Prime characters anyways.
Both games, they were also the last two alive.
Okay. I'd like to point out that the Shadowhawk did pretty decent.
I'd like to point out that we still lost.
But the Shadowhawk did decent. That's irrelevant. Now, if we had one more SRM-6...
Honestly, that build's fine. It's just not ideal for brawls. It's more of a pug build, you know, if you have the UAC-10s.
I was just making a joke.
I know. Tim and Fu, you guys should have invites.
So you want LRM-5s on the Assassin, right?
Absolutely. Maybe an LRM-15.
I was going to say LRM-2s.
That's Lost Tech.
We need to call Buck if we're going to plan a missile mech.
Yeah, straight twos, that's what I have.
Ah, okay, close enough.
He actually made a mech the other day with streaks and SRMs on it. I'm fucking kidding you. Yes. He goes, no, this one's pretty good, I got streaks, and then he had like a medium laser. No.
I'm just saying, we never lost a commander when we ran LRM decks in the commanders.
5 years ago when there wasn't a laser AMS and better maps.
Actually, there was always AMS.
Laser
and
AMS.
The maps were better. And nobody runs AMS in competitive play, so irrelevant.
Nope. Stop it.
Telling you, I got Bonsai on speed dial. I can have him here in a minute.
It is true that nobody runs AMS in competitive.
Well, yeah, because AMS 1 just spreads damage everywhere. If you listened earlier, I called by basically lights are going to grab the cap points. Main body is going to move around the caldera and just rotate around at speed. Once we see them, if they are close, we'll just engage the brawl, or we'll just keep rotating, try and get their back. We'll try and protect their atlas if they push. If they go around and hit our atlas in the back, then we're just going to break out the front attack and pull back.
Yeah, I was in the mech bay. Do you want us to push Eps or Kappa?
Depending on where their starting lance is, yes.
Right.
I mean, we're already bringing Orion, so why not Tearful Onions?
Because SRM brawling is a lot better than LRM volleying, where you can't aim your shots.
Yeah, even though it's a wide open area.
Even though you can't aim your shots.
Well, you're making an assumption there.
Well, you literally can't aim your shots with LRMs. It just goes wherever the heck
you want. Yeah, you say we can aim with anything.
Well, you might not be able to do that.
I aim for the planet. Sometimes I miss.
Impressive.
So you learn to fly then?
Only what I shoot.
Did you pull the hitchhikers and park your atlas on top of a mountain again? Just drop back in an old trial company. Igor was drinking a lot then, obviously, because that's what he did. And he somehow got his atlas on the very tip top of the Alpine Peaks mountain. Hyperbole. It's the spice of life.
There were clan mechs.
Hyperbole. It's the spice of life. Are you almost ready over there? Yep. All good. I guess we're waiting for them to set their lances and change the maps too, but you know.
Can I be in Charlie Lance, please?
Once they set their lances, I will move them.
Just throwing another thing out there, I noticed, I think I got a kill with a arty strike. We're still using those, right? It's my fault for not calling it, but I feel like there was a lot of instances that round that we could have used a few more.
I had some drops ready, but by then we were so mixed up that I didn't want to take the chance.
When I got leg, I dropped one because I was overrun. And you guys ran in, but fortunately I only got 2 team damage.
No, I was talking early on when we heard the call that they were pushing our lights that were on the other sector. When we heard the call that they were pushing our lights, we were moving in, and there was a lot of stragglers and big guys. I dropped one on them, and I felt like maybe we could have capitalized and done a couple more.